As we've reported, we have a healthcare worker shortage nationwide. Nurses are in high demand. At CVPH in Plattsburgh, they've adopted a new approach to attracting and retaining the workforce. Carly Haig is the Associate Chief Nursing Officer. Thanks for joining us.
Thank you for having me.
So tell us what this program is and how it works.
Yeah, so last year we needed to take an innovative approach to bringing in our graduate nurses coming freshly off the heels of, well, still in a pandemic, to make sure that they had some controlled learning experiences as they're entering into their first job as registered professional nurses. So the team took an innovative, different approach to bring in nurses to one dedicated area of our organization for their first 2 to 4 weeks of practice. And on this floor, they cared for patients as a team with each other and dedicated preceptors to make sure that they had consistent learning experiences and additional learning experiences through dedicated education time.
And so then did they stick around after that for longer? Did you notice success in this?
So the DOU, the Dedicated Orientation Unit, is just one part of a great nurse residency program that we have at our organization that has been accredited through the American Nurses Association, American Nurse Credentialing Center, twice now. And it is part of a year-long residency program where we support our nurses in developing confidence and competence in becoming their best nurses, their best selves. And it is, like I said, really an organizational commitment to supporting nurses through their first year of practice. As we know, turnover for nurses is at an all-time high, and even more so during their first year of transitioning to practice.
And so then, does this address the issue that we commonly hear about from nurses of burnout?
There is support throughout the year program for wellness and self-care and how to address passion fatigue and any issues that a nurse might be trying to manage to make sure that they can continue to care for themselves so they can continue to care for their patients. It is part of the nurse residency program and the ongoing support that we provide at the organization.
And the veteran nurses who are helping in this program and you being the educators here, does it put more stress on them, or has their workload been lightened in other areas to make room for this?
I think that's one of the magical parts about the designated orientation unit, because what previously happened is that these nurses during their first 4 weeks of orientation were spread throughout the organization, and preceptors were, with the support of the educators, left to find these education experiences and help them to manage these. This bringing everybody to one unit for minimally the first 4 weeks, and then after their 4 weeks, having them continue their orientation on their core units provides some relief for those preceptors, because there's additional support. Everybody's learning, everybody's looking for experiences, and everybody's in the mindset of what can we do to give these nurses those experiences, and how can we help each other be on the lookout for not only the nurse that I am training, but the nurses that are training around me.
And so with the success that you're seeing, is there a plan to expand this to other hospitals, not just CVPH?
We are currently working, we're in our second year. I would definitely encourage anybody in healthcare right now to get innovative and to look at how we can bring in our new nurses with an arms wide open approach. And I would definitely encourage that. And right now, what we're really concentrating on is supporting our 31 graduate nurses, and we're still hiring to start this year and continue to grow our program here.
Very neat. Thank you so much for your time, and good luck with the rest of that program.
Thank you.